In order to design good architectural design patterns, you need to understand some of the basics for creating efficient communication between microservices. These concepts will help you understand different implementations with respect to microservices architecture patterns. Let's see what are the different ways of communicating between microservices, and we will also see what are the different concepts which we need to implement when we use these different communication strategies. Let's get started.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss any update from Tech Primers.
There are two different ways in which you can communicate across microservices: synchronous and asynchronous way. Before jumping on to examples of what is synchronous and what is asynchronous, I just want to keep the basics tight. So let's understand some of the concepts which we need to understand before getting into the synchronous and the asynchronous way of communicating between microservices. Let's consider there are two different microservices: a UI service and a payment service. UI service has a UI associated with it, and also there is a backend with the UI service, and there is a payment service which does some payment related integrations so that you can complete payments with different banks, credit cards or debit cards or whatsoever. The moment there are two different services which are communicating with each other, the first thing we will have to consider is the transactionality. To understand transactionality, let's understand what is a transaction. A transaction is basically a single unit of work which is performed within a system. It could be a business logic, it could be persisting into a database, or it could be like calling some other service. This is called a transaction. If you want to make sure the transaction is going to be successfully completed and you will not have any side effects to it, that is what is called as a transactionality. So transactionality is making sure your transaction is completed successfully without any side effects. In order to make sure your communication between microservices are successful, you need to make sure the transactionalities are handled. For example, what happens when the payment service goes down? So you need to make sure your transaction is intact. So the UI service needs to take care of the transaction when payment service goes down. So this is called as transactionality. The next one is high availability and resiliency. High availability is making sure your system is always going to be available. In our case, UI service is going to communicate with payment service. So we need to make sure payment service is always there to consume the transaction which UI service is going to send it to. Resiliency is another way of achieving high availability by deploying the same service in some other region, just to make sure that there is no geographical issue with respect to running these services. So this could happen when there are services deployed in a data center, and if there is a network issue with the data center, the whole data center connectivity is lost. In that case, you can have services deployed in another data center, so you won't be affected with these kind of network issues. And resiliency also includes how much time you take to fail over these services from production servers to your disaster recovery servers. The next one is fault tolerance. So what happens if the whole payment service is completely down and there is no resiliency attached to it? Let's consider a case where there is no disaster recovery server which is always up and running, and the production service went down due to some network issue or some issue with the hardware. Now, how will the UI service react to these failures? So that also needs to be considered when we design microservices. So you will have to have additional code in place in the UI service to make sure the failures are not cascaded to the UI service and the user has some seamless experience rather than looking at some stack trace which comes from the payment service. The last one is reliability. So how reliable is the payment service in always achieving a successful transaction? For example, if let's say I am recharging my mobile with a particular service provider, how reliable is the payment service in completing that transaction within a stipulated amount of time so that I don't get any surprises when the transaction is completed? So this is completely different from high availability and resiliency, because so reliability makes sure how your transaction is going to be taken care every single time. Now that we understood the concepts of transactionality, high availability or resiliency, fault tolerance and reliability, let's jump into understand what are the different ways of communicating between microservices. The first one is synchronous communication. Let's take the same example. However, for the sake of the discussion, let's assume that these are communicating using HTTP protocol and the REST representation. So there are different REST endpoints which are being called by the UI service, one for retrieving some payment information, the next one for executing some payments. Since it is a synchronous communication, you can either use HTTP protocol, or in fact you can use gRPCs or remote method invocations. These are different ways of communicating in a synchronous fashion. What is synchronous? If I send a request from the UI service to the payment service responds back with a response. So the UI service waits until the payment service completes its transaction and then gives the response back. Now let's apply these concepts which we learned earlier on these microservices. Transactionality. So how do we handle transactionality? So what happens if the payment service goes down? So the UI service needs to make sure the request is triggered again. Let's say after we executed the REST API call to do a post, the payment service goes down. So what kind of mechanism does the UI service take to re-trigger this payment service call? So that is an example of transactionality. Let's assume inside payment service, if there is a database transaction which is going to happen. For example, when there is a post request, the payment information is persisted onto a database. However, let's say the database is down. So what happens to that particular transaction? So how will the payment service take that transaction and make sure that it persists into the database correctly, because UI service needs the response back. So when you're doing synchronous communication, you will have to make sure the transactionality is handled across microservices, because you're going to retrieve a response back. And if the response is not what you expect, you need to make sure you have a backup plan to make that particular transaction reach an end state. The next one is high availability and resiliency. So in order to make the payment service highly available, you can scale it to multiple instances within the same data center and also across the data center. So that will help you in achieving high availability. Notice that this will not guarantee that the system will be reliable, but it will make sure your system is available. So which basically means your system is always present for you to serve the request back, but it won't guarantee that the response is going to be always successful. A typical example would be IRCTC website during the Tatkal booking times. If you're in India, if you're trying to book a railway ticket during the Tatkal booking time, the system is always available, the website will be available, but sometimes the payment fails or you'll be pushed out because your session took longer time to process. These are simple examples of high available system where the system didn't go down, but the system is not reliable. So the next one is the fault tolerance. What happens to the UI service when the payment service is down? So how is UI service going to re-trigger the request again so that the payment can be executed successfully? So that is what fault tolerance is. And making sure the error which the payment service created does not cascade to the UI service. So we don't want to see exceptional stat trace inside the UI, isn't it? Most of the time you would have seen these kind of issues when there is no fault tolerance. So if we need a clean UI to make sure that there is no unknown error for the user to take action on, you need to handle fault tolerance in the UI service. The last one is the reliability. Like we discussed earlier, as a part of high availability, the system should be reliable every single time so that your transaction is always successful. If the transaction is intermittently successful, then the system is not reliable. So we need to make sure the payment service integrations are perfect so that you can have a reliable payment service. These are the different ways in which you can add these concepts when you're creating synchronous communication between microservices. What happens when you add one more microservice? Again, you need to perform all these concepts on the payment service as well, and you need to make sure the reliability is also handled in the third-party service. So this is what makes a microservice complex. The moment you split a service into two different services or multiple services, you will have to make sure all these are handled in individual services. Every microservices architecture pattern uses these to achieve something or the other. Now let's look at what is asynchronous communication and how is it different from a synchronous communication. Let's take the same example, UI service and the payment service. Instead of doing a REST call, the UI service is publishing onto a queue. So this could be any queue-based implementation. It could be MQ, it could be ActiveMQ, RabbitMQ, whichever queuing system it is. And the payment service is consuming these messages of the same queue. So let's apply the same concepts which we had been looking into. First thing is transactionality. So what happens to the messages when the payment service is down? So UI service might be pushing messages onto the queue. So the UI service doesn't have to do any transactionality handling, especially when the payment service goes down, because UI service doesn't even know that the payment service exists because it's just pumping messages onto a queue. So this is one way of looking at it, where the UI service doesn't even need to handle the transactionality, and the transactionality needs to be handled at the payment service level. Or when there is a queue manager which is down, then you will have to make sure the transactionality is handled. For example, if the queue is completely down instead of the payment service, then you will have to take care of the transactionality. But that's not going to be that often, because usually these queuing systems could be Kafka or RabbitMQ, which could be more reliable than the servers in itself, because most of the time we deploy services, so that is when the service can go down. So that can be one less thing to worry about in terms of asynchronous communication. And I wouldn't say you should completely ignore the transactionality, because you need to still handle transactionality when you're committing back into the queue. So what happens if the message has the rogue data when you're committing back to the queue? Then you will have to make sure the message is processed into a break queue or persist into an error queue. The next one is high availability and resiliency. Though we are doing asynchronous communication, you will still have to make sure your applications are highly available and resilient, because when it comes to processing messages in asynchronous fashion, you need to make sure the user knows what's happening, and you need to make sure the transactions are completed as soon as possible. So in terms of asynchronous communication, there is no guarantee that it will complete within a second or whatsoever. However, you need to still make sure your systems are going to be fast enough. That's why you need to create, again, highly available and resilient system, so you can deploy applications as multiple instances, and also you can deploy across data centers. And to achieve resiliency, you will have to make sure the disaster recovery data center can quickly connect to the same queue if the production instances go down. The next one is fault tolerance. So if you relate to the synchronous way of communication, if the payment service goes down, so the UI service had to do something else so that it can be reprocessed. But in terms of asynchronous communications, since we are using a queue, the transactions are going to be piled up in the queue, and you don't have to implement fault tolerance if there is a failure with respect to payment service. However, you will still have to have a slight amount of fault tolerance, because if the queue goes down, you will have to still have a backup way to find out how you will make sure the error with respect to queue is not cascaded onto the UI service. But still, this is just a less thing to worry about compared to transactions which are going to happen every single time. And finally, reliability. So you need to again make sure payment service is always reliable when it comes to processing these transactions, which is again a property of an individual microservice. Now, what happens when you scale these to multiple microservices? You will have to still again follow these principles: transactionality with respect to committing the messages or back to the queue, and while consuming, you will have to make sure the transaction is completed and you process the message successfully. If you need to make the system resilient and highly available, you will have to scale these instances across data centers and across multiple instances. Fault tolerance can be handled with respect to committing messages and consuming messages off the queue. And finally, making the services reliable will ensure that every single time you have expected response and you don't get any surprises from that particular microservice. I'll just summarize what we discussed. We just discussed about the different communication strategies with respect to communicating between microservices. We saw different concepts. Transactionality is making sure your transactions are getting completed without any errors. High availability ensures that your service is always present to serve requests for the communicating microservice. Resiliency makes sure that even if one data center goes down, the other data center is there to help serve the request. Fault tolerance ensures that you don't get cascaded errors across microservices if one of the microservice call fails. Reliability ensures that your transaction is going to be successful every single time. These are the different concepts which you need to take care while designing microservices communication. Are you doing it? If not, it is high time that you try to implement these in your microservice when you have one or more microservices in your architecture. I hope you found this particular video interesting. As always, if you like the video, go ahead and like it. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to it. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you very much.